Christmas. second verse and the third verse of your life. Okay? So nobody seems to know those by memory, but that's why we're going to have a little help with the commentary here. And hopefully I'll remember to click it when we go to the next verse song. All right, everybody sing along. Ready?
Thank you. the famous Sleigh Ride. Most of you probably have never heard this as a beautifully orchestrated piece, but the arranger, Mark Reimer, created a beautiful vocal arrangement that really imitates the piece that you're so accustomed to hearing on the radio every Christmas. But beautiful piece, Sleigh Ride. After this, we'll have 10 minutes of vision. is David, and Sam and I went to CCM together and got music degrees there together, and he has been a dear friend for several years, and we've sung in several ensembles and things together, and man, she's blessed with a gorgeous voice, isn't she? Wow. Beautiful, powerful. Great to have her part of our group. We're going to sing an old favorite from the 1960s that a lot of us grew up with here. Everybody loves Peanuts, everybody loves good old Charlie Brown, and this is Christmas Time This Year.
Thank you. I think we all love watching this growing up, and of course the Jim Carrey version is hilarious as well. Our brother Paul Stanberry, the conductor for the Butler Philharmonic Orchestra, we're incredibly blessed to have him as part of our ensemble. He's going to come down here and kind of play the Mr. Grinch for us. So, Paul, you want to come on down? He's a very happy guy when he's a good actor, so I believe it's great.
Why, for 53 years, I've put up with it now. knows he's proclaiming, but how hell was I there? Then he died, and off my head. The Grinch came up with one awful idea. I know just what to do with the Grinch left in his throat, and he made a crooked Santa Claus hat and coat. And he talked and thought, what a great Grinchy trick, with his coat and his hat. I look just like St. Nick. All I need is a reindeer. The Grinch looked around, bucks and reindeer are scarce for him to be found. Did that stop the old Grinch? No, the Grinch said, he said, if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one, he said. So he called his dog Max, and he took some red thread and he tied a big horn on the top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sleigh, and he stopped with Max. Get out! Snarled the Grinch. Sleigh started down toward the home for the hooves. They snooze. Tot. All the windows were dark. Quiet snow filled the air. All the hooves were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. And he came to the first little house in the square. This is stop number one. The old witchy caused his and he sprang to the roof. Then he slid down the chimney, a rather tight pitch, but if Scott Wyatt believed, then so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two, then he stuck his head out of that fireplace room where the little stockings caught him in a row. They stockings, he said, are the first things to go. Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around the whole room, and he took every present. Pop-pons and bicycles, roller skates, drums, chickens, tricycles, popcorn and plums. He stuffed them in bags, and the Grinch very nearly stuffed all those bags, one by one, up the chimney. Then he slid to the icebox. He took the whole feast. He took the whole pudding. He took the roast beast. He cleaned out the icebox as quick as a flash. Why, the Grinch, he took the last can of poo hash. He stuffed all the food up the chimney with glee. And now, grinned the Grinch, I will stuff up the tree. So the Grinch grabbed the tree and started to shove. And he heard a small sound, like the coo of a dove. He turned around fast, and he saw a small room. Little Cindy Lou, who was not one, too. The Grinch had been caught by his tiny new daughter who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water. She stared at the Grinch and said,
Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?
Did you know that old Grinch was so smart and so sneaky? He thought of a lie and he thought of it quick. Why, my sweet little tot, the fake Santa Claus cried. Well, there's a light on this tree that won't light on one side, so I'm taking it home to the workshop, my dear. I'll fix it up there. Fooled the child, patted her and got her drink and sent her to bed, and when Cindy Lou went to bed with her cup, he went to the chimney and stuffed the tree up. And the last thing he took was the log from the fire. On the walls he left nothing but hooks and some wire. And one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he did the same thing to the other Ooh's houses, leaving crumbs much too small for the other Ooh's mouses. It was quarter past dawn. All the Ooh's still in bed, all the Ooh's still asleep when he packed up his sled, picked it up with the ropes, the wrappings, the tents, and the tinsel, the trimmings, the trappings. 3,000 feet up on the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode with his load to the tip top to dump it. Hoo-hoo to the hooves, he was graciously humming. They're finding out how the Christmas is coming. They're just waiting for the hooves to do the mouse on a moment or two, then the hooves on a hoo-hoo will all cry, hoo-hoo. Well, that's a noise from the Grinch that I simply must hear, so he paused. And the Grinch put a hand to his ear. He did hear a sound rising over the snow and started to look. The sun was a sad white. The sun sounded merry, but it couldn't be so. But it was merry, very. He stared down at Whoville, and the Grinch popped his eyes and he shook. What he saw was a shocking surprise. Every coon down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing without any presents at all. Why not you, baby? He had stopped Christmas from coming, it came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. And the Grinch, with his Grinch feet ice cold in the snow, stood puzzling and puzzling. How could it be so? It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzle was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't known before. Maybe Christmas, he thought. Does it come from a store? Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. What happened then? Well, in Hoover they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load with the bright morning light. He brought back the toys and the food for the feast, and he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Kiddos to have a bright Christmas this year. We will be supplying them
food for Christmas dinner. You'll be supplying them coats, boots, hats. You'll be supplying them toys that they would like to have. That's exactly where the money will go. It will all go to that purpose. I will take these funds with me Monday morning and deliver them directly to Mrs. Griffith, and she will be sure that these 156 families she's serving will be served by these finances. So, again, if you are able to give, we would love for you to do that. We're going to pass around the baskets at this time, and we're going to sing "Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas."
Sing-along for our very last song. Why don't you stand up and sing with us? We're going to do "We Wish You a Merry Christmas."
great songs. We all remember the first verse. And then remember, there's something I'm thinking, put it in there. I remember that. And then we'll wait until we get some. Go ahead, Jingle. Great song. You all have been a wonderful audience. I love looking out and seeing the smiles and the cheer and the childlike look on the faces. So it's a beautiful thing. I kind of feel like we've accomplished our mission to bring you back to childhood. And thank you so much for being here to support our first ever. This is the first time this choir has sung together. We are quite a combination of people. We have some people that have never sung in a choir before, brand spanking new. We have some very young people, 14, 15 years old, on up to pros, like Paul, the director of the Butler Philharmonic Orchestra, and kids that have graduated from CCM. I say the eighth grade of us, but nonetheless, a lot of variations of ability, and so it's just been a joy for us all to come together and make this beautiful music. So thank you so much for coming out to support us tonight. We just want you to know that right after we get done singing this song, we're going to have a reception in the back with all kinds of goodies. Please stay around. Let us get to know you a little better. Let's visit and enjoy some Christmas cheer one with another. Here we go. We wish you a Merry Christmas.